have some fun with music. Stir crazy. Let's have some fun. Stir crazy. We're number one.
Hi. I want to talk to you about singing. Singing. Yes, singing. Now, some people say they don't sing. They can't sing. Some people don't like to sing. What do you think about that? Don't you think that everybody can and should sing? Well, I'm going to talk to you about some things today that will prove that everybody can and should sing. And I'd like to start out with this story. There was a journalist. He went to Africa. What's a journalist? Can someone tell me? Say it, just shout it out. Yes, a journalist is someone who writes about the news and sometimes just tells the news flash, sometimes goes deep into it, researches. Well, this journalist was researching and he went over to Africa and he spent a long time being in a village, a certain small village in Africa. Well, every day, at the end of the day, people would get together, they'd be together, they would sing and dance and talk. And when they sang, the journalist, he wouldn't sing because he didn't think he could sing. Part of this story that I really like is that at one time, a young man from the village was going to live in the city and work there. It was a very long way to the city. And the people in the village, including his father, didn't know when they would see him again. And the father, feeling responsible and kind of sad at the same time, said, I have to communicate or tell my son what to expect when he gets to the big city. I have to show my love to my son by communicating with him. And so the father went into a very long song, and it went on for over an hour. He was just telling his son things that he needed to do in the city to stay safe and be the kind of person the father wanted him to be. So here's my point, that if you want to say something, you can communicate with the song. Opera is just kind of where you have songs instead of words. And everything is sung. A musical is where you have words and music. That's fun too. But let's go back to this village in Africa so I can get to the point of the story at right now. The point of the story is right now that the people started to ask this journalist who is from America, why don't you sing? And he said, I can't sing. The people were shocked that he would say such a thing. They said, well, you're speaking to us. You can sing. And it put a different spin on it for the journalist. He said, well, if I can speak, yes, I can sing. And he started to sing. So here's my point for you, and maybe your parents too. If you say you can't sing, you can. If you can speak, you can sing. And I want you to start singing now. Well, what should you sing about? Well, you could sing about anything. What you had for lunch. You could sing about what's in your heart right now. You could sing about what you like. I like to do that. You can stay on one note, like we have before in some of these meetings that you and I have had. You could say, I like ice cream. What else do you like? I like, Think of something else you like. I like... Let's do one more. I like... See, you just made up a song. Start with one note, start with some words. So look, I'm encouraging you to keep writing your stories down during this special time in the life of our city. But I'm also encouraging you to write to take what you write down and make it into songs. There are all kinds of ways to creating songs, and I'm going to tell you just a few of them right now. You could write a poem, and then whatever comes to your head, you could sing it. Whatever melody comes to your head, you could sing it. If you know a little bit about writing music down, you could write a melody, and then you could make some words to it. You could even collaborate. Have your brother or sister write the words, you write the music, maybe they don't play music. Now you could take some chords. I'm talking to you musicians now, or you know what? This is not too hard to figure out. You could take some chords. I just pulled that out of my head. Come up with some chords you like and just repeat them over and over and then put a little melody over it. Well, that's enough specifics because I mainly just want you to get the point that you should make up songs. You can practice this when you're outside riding your bike, playing in the yard, walking on the bike trail, looking at sandhill cranes that are going through our community right now on their way up north. They've been coming from down south. You can do this anywhere. And like the journalist in Africa who thought he couldn't sing, you just have to start. You have to sing. Now, you know about the four W's? That's who, what, where, and when. Who, what, where, and when. You could apply this to your singing. I know what you're saying. You're saying, no, it's the five W's, Miss Susan, and it's got a how with it. And I know what you're saying. Some of you know the five W's. Some of you know the five W's and how. There's different ways of using this concept when you're writing stories, when you're writing your stories down, like I encouraged you to. But the four W's is a good way to consider how I'm going to write songs. Now, who, what, when, that could be anywhere, and where, that could be any time. Oh, I guess we've got it covered. Who, what, when, and where. You are going to write songs anytime, anywhere. Will you do that, please? Just let it go. Just start to sing. Hey, there's this guy. His name is Jeremy Messersmith. He's been writing songs for a long time. He's one of Minnesota's most beloved songwriters now. So Jeremy taught me this song, and I've been teaching it to a lot of kids. Maybe some of you out there are watching. Maybe some of you saw Jeremy Messersmith when he came to our own Sheldon Theater here in Red Wing. I'm going to sing this song for you and see what an easy subject songwriting, excuse me, I messed up again. I'm going to show you what a song can be like. This is Jeremy Messersmith's song. I think I know these words. You probably know them better than I do. Gotta say the future's awesome. Everything is A-okay. All the work is done by robots. Every day is Saturday. Future people all have jetpacks, fly around in flying cars. There's so much that I could tell you, but the coolest part by far. Everybody gets a kitten, a new one every single day. Everybody gets a kitten, you can name if you want, or you can give it away. Do you know that song? Isn't it great? Now let's just sing the chorus again together. Everybody gets a kitten, a new one every single day. Everybody gets a kitten, you can name if you want, or you can give it away. You know, I really like the words of the second verse too in this song. They go like this. Jeremy Messersmith, he wrote this song. There is no disease or hunger. Hey, let's try to sing that. There is no disease or hunger. And here are the next words. Listen carefully, then you can sing them with me. Zero poverty or war. Zero poverty or war. Life is just a giant party. Life is just a giant party. No one here is ever bored. No one here is ever bored. All the factories burn rainbows. All the factories burn rainbows. You can build a house on Mars. You can build a house on Mars. There's so much I could tell you. There's so much that I could tell you. But, you know this one, but the coolest part by far. Everybody gets a kitten, new one every single day. Everybody gets a kitten, you can name if you want, or you can give it away.
Here's William, ready for another joke break? What's the difference between a piano and a fish? You can't tune a fish. It's gonna be a big one.
Hi, this is Mike again. Happy to see you here on Stir Crazy. Today, we're going to talk about the rhythm of words, okay? Or getting rhythm from words to play on your instruments, either your instruments that you made, or if you have a drum, you know, or any of the various things we've been talking about. We're looking at all these different instruments that we talked about. And words or numbers have a rhythm. When you talk or when you sing, that's a rhythm, okay? And I'll show you an example of what I mean. So the first one we're going to do is we're going to play our name, okay? So my name is Mike, and this might be what it would sound like. My name is Mike, okay? So you could play your name. My name is Mike, all right? Now I could also go, my name is Mike, or my name is Mike. So there's a couple different ways that the words would give you a rhythm. So that's great, you know, and you could just make up your own words, you know, you can make up your own rhythm, see what you come up with. Just have fun with it. So here's a couple different ideas. How about the alphabet? We all know the alphabet, right? So let's play the alphabet. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and use your low sounds and high sounds. We'll start over again. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Now I've said my ABCs. Tell me what you think of me. How'd you do? I bet you did great. Great job. So that was the alphabet. Okay, another idea are numbers. Let's count from 1 to 20, okay? And we'll play our drum, or let's do a different instrument. Let's do a shaker, okay?
How about if we do, let's see what we'll use. Let's use the popcorn, okay? So we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40. 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50. I know I said we're going to go to 20, but we went to 50. So numbers, that's another thing for rhythm, okay? Also, how about some little nursery rhymes, little songs that you know? I'm not going to do the whole song, you know, or the whole nursery rhyme. You guys probably know them, and you could do them on your own, but I'll just do a little bit of a couple of them just to give you an idea. So let's start out with Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, okay? Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. That was a good one, okay? Let's do something else. Let's pick one of our other little homemade instruments. How about, do you remember this if you were here on the first day that we got together? This is a paint scraper. Pretty crazy, right? Paint scraper. And how about we play the paint scraper with a wrench, okay? It's paint scraper and a wrench. So let's do Ba Ba Black Sheep. Remember that one? Okay. Ba ba black sheep. I have to read the words here so I don't get these messed up, so excuse me for looking down. But ba ba black sheep, have you any wool? Yes, sir, three bags full. Ba ba black sheep, have you any wool? Yes, sir, three bags full. Let's do it. Ba ba black sheep, have you any wool? Yes, sir, three bags full. Ba ba black sheep. Have you any wool? Yes, sir, three bags full. Pretty good, huh? Okay, you could do this at home right now. How about the farmer in the dell? Let's pick a different sound. How about one of these guys, okay? I'm gonna get this. This is a big sound ring, okay, and a soft mallet. So let's try the farmer in the dell, okay? The farmer in the dell, the farmer in the dell. Hi-ho the derry-o, the farmer in the dell, the farmer in the dell, the farmer in the dell. Hi-ho the derry-o, the farmer in the dell. We could do it a simpler way like this. The farmer in the dell, the farmer in the dell. Hi-ho the derry-o, the farmer in the dell. That was with every syllable of the word, so you can do that too. Good job, you guys. Okay, so how about this next one? This was my daughter's favorite when she was little. I'm a little teapot. This goes, I'm a little teapot, short and stout. Here is my handle, here is my spout. When I get all steamed up, I just shout, tip me over and pour me out. I'm a little teapot, short and stout. Here is my handle, here is my spout. When I get all steamed up, I just shout, tip me over and pour me out. Okay, so those are rhythms, rhythms that words make. Pick songs that you like, maybe a poem, a nursery rhyme, play your name, play numbers, anything. Pick up a little piece of anything, a story, anything with words, and listen for the rhythms, the rhythms of the words. So have fun with that, and we'll see you next time. Thank you.
Hi, this is Ronald. How cool is that?
Did you know that this is a kalimba, also known as an African thumb piano?
These originated from the ancient African instruments called the mellophones. This is a metal time kalimba. Wooden time kalimbas like this one were first made about 3,000 years ago. They have beautiful tones and are a symbol of pride with an African heritage. How cool is that?
Hi, this is Anna here at ArtReach. Today I am going to tell you about an artist named Georges Seurat and a style of painting that he pioneered called Pontillism. So Georges Seurat was born in 1859 in France, and when he was a young man, he was learning about how people see. At that time, doctors and scientists and artists were all learning a lot about how our eyes work and how our brains interpret the things that we see with our eyes. And a whole school of thought came about called chromoluminarianism. Super big word, chromoluminarianism. Chromo means color. Luma means light, so chromoluminarianism is all about color and light and how our eyes see color and light. And so he developed this style of painting called Pontillism, where a whole painting is made with a ton of tiny little dots. One of his most famous paintings is this one here, a Sunday afternoon on the island of La Grande Jatte. This painting hangs in the Art Institute in Chicago, and the actual painting is about 7 feet tall, so taller than most people, and 10 feet wide, so even wider than it is tall. It took him 2 years to paint that painting, and part of the reason is because it's made up of tiny little dots, little teeny tiny brush strokes. If you look at this, we've got this lady over here with the umbrella and a guy standing next to her. This is a zoomed in picture of that lady. So you can kind of see all those tiny little dots. This picture is even more zoomed in, not just of that lady. This is actually two separate pictures. But if I put them right up close, you can see it's tons of tiny little dots. And when it's really up close to the camera, if you're up close, you can see that it's tiny little dots. But if I hold it way back here, the colors kind of blend together. I have another thing to show you that I made. So on the computer, I did a series of red dots and blue dots, and this is what that looks like. So up close, let's let that focus. Up close, it's red dots and blue dots. But if I hold it way back here, it looks kind of purplish. Just like if you mix red paint and blue paint, it would make purple. When those dots are so far away, our eyes blend those colors together, and just like blending paint, makes a new color. So that is the style of painting that Georges Seurat is the most famous for, that Pontillism. And I have some other pictures of more recent Pontillist paintings. This one is from 1909 by Paul Signac. He's also very famous for Pontillism. Here's one that I like. Way back here, just looks like a normal eye. But up close, tons of tiny little dots. All right, so my challenge to you is to make your own Pontillist painting. So that's a painting made up of tiny little dots. And for this, you will need some paper and either markers or paints. If you're using markers, we'll go ahead and make the base of our tree. So if you want to draw some lines to get that started for you, you can. You could either use a pencil or your marker. I'll do it with my marker so that it's easier for you to see. So we have the trunk of our tree and some branches going out. You can put as many branches as you want, and you can thicken that trunk up a little. But remember, we're doing our painting with lots of tiny dots. So let's make our branches out of tiny little dots. This is gonna take you a while. Challenge yourself to make as much of your picture out of little dots as you can. So lots of tiny little dots. And then that's kind of what trees look like right now, right? Kind of brown and bare. Spring is coming. So let's add some little leaves and buds to our tree. Just like Georges Seurat used lots of different colors to kind of combine to make one, we can do the same thing with our tree. We can use different shades of green. And around here, when those buds first start to come out on the tree, they look kind of yellow. So we can take our yellow marker and make tiny little dots. If your markers are big enough, you can just kind of push them into the paper quickly. And you don't have to make little circles. Here's that up close. If you're gonna do painting, what I like to use instead of a paintbrush is a little cotton swab because it's already dot-shaped. So we can use some blue and yellow paint, mix them together to make green, and make our dots like that. I'm gonna move this closer so you can see it a little better. And I can use just some yellow. And what's fun when you're painting like this is with this little cotton swab, you don't have to wash it out between colors. We can just switch back and forth from one color to another. So it kind of blends together on that little cotton swab too. So we're making a lot of different variations of yellow, blue, and green to fill in all those little dots. And up close, it's gonna look like yellow and blue and green. But from a distance, it looks like how our leaves look in the beginning of spring. All right, you go ahead and take your time and make your very own painting comprised completely of dots. One thing I want you to think about is if you're doing your painting on or drawing on a piece of paper this size, imagine if it was an entire wall made of tiny little dots and how long that would take you. That's why it took Georges Seurat 2 years to complete that painting I showed you. All right, have fun and happy creating.
Sit alone and watch your the watch the stars on videos for hours and hours. We are the need to use our ears. Our music changes through the years. Let's hope you never leave a friend. Like all good things, on you we depend. Stick around, cause we might miss you when we grow tired of all these visuals.
I'm Megan from the Red Wing Public Library, and I'm here today to sing a couple of rainy day songs. So, the first one you might know, the second one I'm pretty sure that you absolutely do know, but I'm going to teach you the first one, and then we're going to do the second one. They just go so well together that I had to do two of them. So, grab your galoshes and your umbrella and get ready to go, because the first song is about a day where it rains and 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 it doesn't stop, even though we're very, very hopeful that it's not going to rain anymore. So this song is called It Ain't Gonna Rain No More. We're gonna start with the water up to our toes. So hopefully you do have your galoshes on, or if you're like me and you don't really like to wear shoes, splashing in puddles and bare feet is a-okay. All right, here we go. It ain't gonna rain no more, no more. It ain't gonna rain no more. Oh no, it's up to my toe. But it ain't gonna rain no more, no more. But it does. It just keeps raining. And now the water is up to my knee. Ooh, I don't know. Hopefully those galoshes are really tall. It ain't gonna rain no more, no more. It ain't gonna rain no more. Oh gee, it's up to my knee. But it ain't gonna rain no more, no more. But it does, it just keeps raining. And now it's up to my thigh. And even if I have waders on, they're definitely not tall enough. It ain't gonna rain no more, no more. It ain't gonna rain no more. Oh my, it's up to my thigh. But it ain't gonna rain no more, no more. But it does, it just keeps raining. And now it's up to my middle. It ain't gonna rain no more, no more. It ain't gonna rain no more. Oh, fiddle, it's up to my middle. But it ain't gonna rain no more, no more. But it does, it just keeps raining and raining and raining. And now it's up to my neck. My neck, it's all inside my rain slicker, everywhere. It ain't gonna rain no more, no more. It ain't gonna rain no more. Oh heck, it's up to my neck. But it ain't gonna rain no more, no more. But it does, it just keeps raining and raining and raining and raining and raining and raining. And now it's up to my head. Oh, nothing for it. It ain't gonna rain no more, no more. It ain't gonna rain no more. Oh dread, it's up to my head. So I'm just gonna swim on home.
All right. Sometimes there's nothing to do but just swim on home. All right. And the next one, which I know you all know, is the Itsy Bitsy Spider. So if you know the actions, do it along and get your spiders out. I won't be able to do that since I'll be playing, but you can do that at home. All right. The Itsy Bitsy Spider went up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the Itsy Bitsy Spider went up the spout again. All right. Well, it's time to come inside. Take off your galoshes. Hang up your raincoat. And get something nice and hot to drink. Tea or cocoa, whatever you fancy. All right, thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next time.
Hey everybody, we hope you like Stir Crazy. Don't forget to tune in again next week for a new episode. One, two, sing along. Stir Crazy, let's have some